This is an indoor circuit board of a Hisense Inverter Mini Split Air Conditioner. This is the remote of this air conditioner, and it has Hisense branding on it. This circuit has gone bad. I think the high electricity has passed through this circuit board. Due to this, the fuse of this circuit board has blown up. I haven't checked what other problem this circuit board has. I will check the rest of the issues in this circuit board with you. This is the NTC sensor installed here. It has also a hole in it. This means this component in this circuit board is bad, and the problem could have gone further to the SMPS circuit. The good thing is that these capacitors seem like they are okay. They are not bulged. They could also go bad. Not a big deal. Now, let's test this circuit board. What else could we find faulty? I will test it with the multimeter, because a multimeter will give us a good idea of what else is bad in this circuit board. So, as I showed you, this NTC sensor has a hole inside it. This gives us an idea that the power surge was very high. A bridge rectifier is made of four diodes right after the NTC sensor. Let's test these diodes. For it, I will put the multimeter on diode mode. I will put the probes on this first diode, and let's see what reading we get. Here, the reading is zero directly. I will test the reading by changing the polarity of the probes. This first diode is bad. The second diode is also showing zero reading on the multimeter. After changing the polarity of the probe, it still shows zero reading. We'll also check these two more diodes connected ahead, but a layer of silicon is put upon it. Let me remove it, and then I will test it. Now, I have cleaned the silicon layer from the diodes. The third diode is also bad, showing zero reading. The fourth diode is also bad. All these diodes are bad. Let's test this fifth diode. What does it show? These diodes are inside the circuit board, and they could show bad inside the circuit board because they are connected to each other. The diodes. The NTC sensor will be replaced. Other than this, its fuse will also be replaced. I will also have to check its varistor. Testing it is also important. This is the varistor sign from the backside of the circuit board. To test it, I will put the multimeter on ohm mode. I will place both the multimeter probes on the pins of the varistor. Let's see whether we get any value or not. It is showing almost 16 ohms, which is not good. This means the varistor could be bad. The best way to test is by removing it from the circuit board. I have removed all the components we tested. All five diodes are bad. The fuse is bad. The NTC sensor is bad. I told you that the varistor could also be bad. I told you if it is not showing the correct value inside the circuit board, this doesn't mean that it is faulty. So, I will test it to confirm that it is fine. I will put the multimeter on ohm mode. I will put the multimeter probes on its pins. The multimeter is not showing any reading of the varistor. In this situation, the varistor is fine. I will test it by changing the polarity of the probes. It has no issue in it. After installing new components, I will check the SMPS circuit as well. The physical condition of the SMPS circuit seems fine right now. Other than this, I have checked these resistors. They are fine. Now, I will take a little risk after installing the diodes. I will pass electricity through it and check whether its switching IC works or not. I have installed new diodes, NTC sensor, and the fuse in this circuit board. Now, I will power it on and check whether this circuit board turns on or not. I will pass electricity through the circuit board. The display worked. Now, I will turn it on with the remote. I am holding the display on the wrong side, so I will rotate it. The display is showing 16 degrees. This means we have successfully fixed this circuit board. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch the next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.